Welcome, everyone. Today, we'll discuss a fascinating and very important topic: how to extract microscopic gold from rocks using a technique based on Aqua Regia. It may seem complicated, but it's actually straightforward if we follow the steps carefully and adhere to safety precautions. I'll guide you through the process step by step, but before we start, let's first understand, what is microscopic gold? Microscopic gold refers to gold present in rocks in extremely small quantities, invisible to the naked eye. This is why we need special processes to extract it. About Aqua Regia. Aqua Regia is a mixture of hydrochloric acid and nitric acid in a 3:1 ratio. This mixture is extremely powerful and can dissolve gold, one of the most chemically resistant metals. But before we proceed, I want to emphasize that handling Aqua Regia is highly dangerous. Always ensure you wear gloves, safety goggles, masks, and work in a well-ventilated area. The first step in this process is to prepare the gold-containing rocks. Crushing the rocks. Start by breaking large rocks into smaller pieces using a hammer or crusher. The goal here is to make the grinding process easier. Grinding the rocks. Once the rocks are broken into smaller pieces, grind them into a very fine powder using a ball mill or grinder. The finer the powder, the more effective the gold extraction process will be. Roasting the rocks is not always necessary, but it is very important in certain cases, especially if the rocks contain sulfide minerals or organic impurities that prevent the extraction of gold using Aqua Regia. When is roasting necessary? Presence of sulfide minerals such as pyrite or argentite. Sulfide minerals can trap microscopic gold inside them, making it difficult to dissolve in Aqua Regia. Roasting converts sulfides into oxides, making the gold more exposed to acids. Presence of organic carbon or oils. If the rocks contain organic materials, roasting burns them off and prevents them from interfering with the chemical process. How to perform roasting? Grinding the rocks. Grind the rocks into a very fine powder. Gradual heating. Place the powder in a special furnace or heat-resistant crucible. Start heating the powder slowly to avoid sudden explosions. Gradually increase the heat to around 600-700 degrees Celsius. Removing gases. Ensure the area is well ventilated as roasting releases toxic gases such as sulfur dioxide. Cooling. After roasting is complete, allow the powder to cool before moving on to the Aqua Regia treatment stage. Benefits of roasting. Breaks down the mineral structure that traps gold. Improves the efficiency of gold dissolution with Aqua Regia. Reduces chemical consumption. Can it be skipped? If the rocks are clean and do not contain sulfide minerals or organic materials, the roasting step can be skipped. However, in most cases where the rocks contain microscopic gold inside sulfides, roasting is necessary to ensure successful extraction. Conclusion? Roasting is not always necessary, but it significantly improves the efficiency of the chemical process in many cases. Now that we have our finely ground rock powder, the next crucial step is to clean it to ensure the removal of any dust or surface impurities. These impurities could affect the chemical process later, so this step is essential for achieving the best results. We start by adding water to the rock powder in the container. The goal here is to wash away any dirt or unwanted surface particles that might be clinging to the powder. As you can see, when we add water, it helps to loosen and remove the unwanted impurities on the surface of the powder. This is important because any remaining impurities could affect the reaction when we introduce Aqua Regia later on. Next, we gently stir the mixture to ensure the water is well mixed with the powder and to remove any fine dust particles effectively. Next, we gently stir the mixture to ensure the water is well mixed with the powder and to remove any fine dust particles effectively. Be careful not to stir too vigorously, as this could cause the powder to clump. The goal is to wash off the surface particles, not to break apart the powder. Once we gently stir the mixture, we let it sit for about a minute to allow the heavier particles to settle at the bottom. This way, The remaining water on top will contain fewer impurities. After a minute, we carefully pour off the water. You'll notice that the water has become clearer. This means we've successfully removed the dust and surface impurities. Repeat this process if necessary. It's always best to wash the powder until the water runs completely clear, indicating that all impurities have been removed. Once the powder is completely cleaned, it is ready to move on to the next stage of the gold extraction process. A clean powder ensures that the reaction with Aqua Regia will be more efficient and precise. Cleaning the rock powder may seem like a simple step, but it is a crucial one to ensure that no unwanted contaminants interfere with the chemical process of gold extraction. Now that we have properly cleaned the powder, we can move on to dissolving the gold using Aqua Regia. Dissolving the gold with Aqua Regia, adding Aqua Regia to the powder. Place the powder in an acid-resistant glass container. Gradually add Aqua Regia to the powder while stirring gently. The acids will begin to dissolve the gold present in the powder, leaving the mixture. Leave the mixture for 24 hours, stirring occasionally to allow the gold to dissolve completely. Filtering the solution. Use a paper or cotton filter to separate the liquid containing the dissolved gold from the remaining insoluble rock residue. Be sure to keep the liquid as it contains the dissolved gold. Always remember to work in a well-ventilated area as this reaction releases toxic gases. What is the importance of filtering the Aqua Regia solution? Filtering the Aqua Regia solution is a crucial and important step in the process of extracting gold and precious metals. The main goal of this step is removing impurities. When gold is dissolved in Aqua Regia, the solution may contain impurities and other metals such as silver, copper, or iron. Filtering removes these undissolved solid materials to ensure a pure solution. Preventing chemical interference. The presence of impurities may cause unwanted reactions during subsequent steps, affecting the efficiency of the final gold extraction process, improving the quality of the final product. Filtering helps ensure that the extracted gold will be of high purity and free from contaminants. Is heating the Aqua Regia solution necessary in the extraction process? Heating the Aqua Regia solution can be necessary in some cases, depending on the target material and the goal of the process. Here are some clarifications on this topic. Increasing the reaction rate. Heating the Aqua Regia solution increases the rate of the chemical reaction between the acid and metals, leading to faster and more efficient dissolution of metals like gold or platinum. Improving solubility. Some metals may require higher temperatures to dissolve completely in Aqua Regia. Heating helps stimulate the reaction between the acids and metals, increasing their solubility. Removing organic materials or impurities. Sometimes, heating the solution helps accelerate the removal of organic impurities or undissolved materials that may hinder the extraction process or be harmful to it. Controlling concentration and pH. By heating Aqua Regia, operators can control the acid concentration and pH to ensure optimal conditions for the reaction between acids and target metals. Notes. Caution is required when heating Aqua Regia as the acids are very strong and can be dangerous. Heating should be done in a safe environment with proper ventilation. Heating is not always necessary, as in some cases, using Aqua Regia at room temperature can be an effective alternative depending on the type of metal and the required reaction. Precious metals like gold can be extracted from Aqua Regia using the electrochemical process of electrolysis. This method is sometimes used to recover gold and other metals after dissolving them in Aqua Regia. Here's a simplified explanation of the process. After dissolving the metal, the solution is diluted and filtered to remove solid impurities. Chemical additives such as ammonium chloride are sometimes used to precipitate unwanted metals or enhance extraction efficiency, but they can be omitted. Electrolysis process. Two electrodes, cathode and anode, are immersed in the solution. When an electric current is passed, the precious metal, such as gold, begins to deposit on the cathode negative electrode. Other impurities either remain in the solution or deposit on the anode, collecting the deposited metal. Once the process is complete, the cathode is removed and the deposited metal, usually gold, is collected. Final purification. The resulting metal may require additional purification to remove any remaining impurities. Important notes. Aqua regia is highly toxic and corrosive, so it must be handled with extreme caution and under safe conditions. Precision in controlling the electric current is essential to avoid depositing impurities along with the precious metal. The cost and energy requirements of this method depend on the concentration of metals in the solution. In the electrolysis process for extracting precious metals from aqua regia, the choice of anode positive electrode and cathode negative electrode depends on several factors, such as the type of target metal and the required efficiency. Here's an explanation of suitable options. Anode positive electrode, used in the solution and may be reactive or inert. Options. Lead, resistant to corrosion in acidic environments. Platinum or ruthenium-coated titanium, ideal but expensive. Carbon graphite, economical but deteriorates over time. Cathode negative electrode. The metal gold is deposited on it. Options. Copper, good conductor of electricity and easy to remove deposited metal. Stainless steel, corrosion resistant and reusable. Carbon graphite, less common because it deteriorates quickly. Recommended choices. Cathode, copper for easy gold deposition and removal. Anode, graphite or lead for durability in acidic environments. Tips. Avoid using materials that strongly react with aqua regia, such as aluminum. Clean the electrodes after each use to remove unwanted deposits. For better efficiency, you can try inert electrodes like platinum or ruthenium-coated titanium. Warning. Aqua regia is an extremely hazardous substance, so proper safety equipment such as gloves and safety goggles must be used. Conduct the process in a well-ventilated area to avoid inhaling toxic fumes. Unfortunately, after examining this sample, it was confirmed that it contains gold. However, the detected quantities are not significant. Thank you for your follow-up and interest.